Hello everyone, this is Anisha Sharma and this video is about carry forward and setting off of losses under the Income Tax Act. First of all, let us understand what is set off of losses. So, whenever the net result of an assessment year in respect of any source under any head of income is a loss, the assessee is entitled to set off the amount of such loss against his income from any other source under the same head. For example, if a person is having two businesses, business A and business B, if he is having a loss in business A, that loss can be set off against the profit that he'll earn from business B. But the set off should be against the same head of income. If it is a business income, it should be set off against business income only. If it is from house property, it should be set off against house property only. So, however, this set off is not applicable on when the loss is from activity owning for or maintaining horse races, or against long-term capital loss, means these losses cannot be set off. However, when an individual transfers any asset either directly or indirectly other than house property to a spouse, then that transfer, the spouse who's transferring, that is the transferor, would be liable to pay the tax for against the spouse. Next come carry forward of losses. So if it is not possible to set off the loss in that particular assessment year, then that loss can be carried forward to coming further financial years. Now, this carry forward can not be carried forward for any losses that is in salary or losses which is under the head of income from other sources. Next, we'll be discussing in brief section 70, 71 and 72 of the Income Tax Act. These section talks about the setting off of losses and carry forward of losses. We'll be discussing them in brief. The first loss that we are going to talk about is loss from house property. So this loss from house property can be set off against income from other house property or any other head of income which is up to a maximum limit of 2 lakh rupees. Next loss is loss from business or profession. So this loss from business and profession can be set off against income from any other business or profession or any other head of income except from the head of salary. So if you're having a business and you are a salaried employee, your income from salary cannot be used to set off the loss that you have incurred in the business. Here, income from any other business or profession includes speculative business and business from the horse race, etc. And here, if the loss that is incurred in a subsidiary company, then that loss of the subsidiary company cannot be set off against the parent company's profit. The next loss that we are going to talk about is loss from speculation. So the loss from speculation would be set off against income from speculations. But the income from an illegal speculation cannot be set off against a legal loss in a legal speculation. The fourth loss that we are going to talk about is short-term capital loss. So the short-term capital loss would be set off against short-term capital gain or long-term capital gain. Next is long-term capital loss. It will be set off against long-term capital gain. Next is loss from activity of owning and maintaining a racehorse. That would be set off against income from activity of owning and maintaining horse race. Section 72 talks about a loss from house property. So this will be set off in the following 8 years, income from house property. The next loss is less loss from business and profession under section 72 in following 8 years income from business or profession. The next loss would be loss from speculation under section 72 in the 4 years income from speculation. The fourth point is short-term capital loss. In the following 8 years, it will be set off against short-term capital gain or long-term capital gain. Again, then loss from long-term capital, it would be set off in 8 years against long-term capital itself. The sixth point is loss from activity of owning and maintaining race, horse race. It would be set off in the next 4 years and from the income from activity of owning and maintaining horse race itself. Thank you.